Welcome to the NASCAR 5-Hour Energy Cup Series for Season 3, Race 9. This race is sponsored by the Sharpie Car 2000. Make sure to check out his channel. Link will be in the description below. This is it. 10 months of waiting and it all comes down to this. Four drivers will be fighting for a championship in this 32-car field, and one driver comes home with a grand prize. Your drivers to watch for today is the Championship 4 contender, starting with Brad Keslowski on the pole. The Penske cars, including his, are phenomenal at short tracks. Keep an eye on him. Then we have Kevin Harvick, also really good, as he has 9 wins in a NASCAR Cup Series. Can he win here again? But in the NASCAR 500 Cup Series, we will see. Denny Hamlin rounds out the top 5. He's shown some promising speeds here and in the past a few races since the playoffs began. But can he capitalize off of it today for the championship race? And then you have Kurt Busch starting in P8. Not much has Busch been in the spotlight at this track, but I'm sure he's got something up his sleeve that'll shock the field, including me. Maybe. Before we start this race, we'll go sidetrack for the command, and please welcome Awesome Man 24GG.
Drivers, start your engines!
Thank you, Awesome Man 24GG, for that amazing command. 32 cars fire up for the last race of the season, and as always, we'll go through your qualifying results. Alright, in row 1, it's 2 of the Championship 4 contenders, Kevin Harvick and Brad Keselowski. In row 2 is Joey Logano and Chase Elliott. In row 3 is another Championship 4 contender, Denny Hamlin. 2 is outside, Brendan Poole in the 27th. And then in row 4 we have the 12 of Ryan Blaney, and then we have another Championship 4 contender, Kurt Busch. Then we have 7-time champion Jimmy Johnson, or Jimmy Johnson, to his outside, Alex Bowman. Then we have the 10 of Eric Almirola and the 21 of Matt DiBenedetto. Then we have the 8 of Tyler Reddick next to his outside stage winner, MTJ. Then we have Clint Bowyer next to Austin the Ace Dillon. Then we have Kyle Busch next to Willie B. Byron. Then we have Dap Jones boy Eric Jones with the GOAT, Ty Dillon. Then we have the rookie who won at Kentucky, Cole Custer, next to Matt Kenseth. Then we have John Hunter Nemechek with Ryan Rocketman Newman. Then we have Bubba Wallace next to Christopher Bell. Then we have the 17 of Chris Buescher next to Ricky Stenhouse Jr. Then we have the 37 of Ryan Preece next to Michael McDowell. Then we have Corey LaJoie and the Watermelon King, Ross Chastain. Before we go racing for 10 laps, here is Jimmy Johnson, the pace to fill in his final start of his career and to honor his accomplishments in a NASCAR Cup Series. Thank you, Jimmy Johnson. We will miss you. Clint Bowyer also makes his final start in a number 14 Ford Mustang, a very iconic character here in the NASCAR world. We also thank him for the great memories. And finally, Matt Kenseth sets to leave the NASCAR 5-Hour Energy Cup Series after this race. He won the 2003 NASCAR Cup Series Championship and substituting for Kyle Larson from the race in Michigan all the way through the end of Season 3, so we also hate to see him leave, but Ross Chastain will take over the new ride in 2021. Race info. It's a 10-lap race, like I already said. Four drivers will compete for a championship, and Kevin Harvick, among the Championship 4 contenders, could win his second championship. All right, boys and girls, it's time to go racing here in the desert in Phoenix. It should be a good one. Green flag is in the air. Keselowski sails it into turns 1 and 2. Woo! Denny Hamlin wiggles in the middle of the turn, but it's not going to hurt him too much as we enter the back straightaway. Bradley's the first lap out of 10 today. Here comes Denny Hamlin passing him in the dogleg, along with Hendrick teammates Chase Elliott and Jimmy Johnson in second and third. Look at this. 3 wide for second. Now 4 wide for second into 3. Here comes Kurt Busch taking the lead away from Hamlin as he slides up the track. Goodness me. Here comes the 9 with the... Oh, he's loose! Can he save it? Hang on! Yes, he can! He saved it in those turns, drifted, but falls back. And now here comes Kevin Harvick leading lap with Martin Truex Jr. right behind him. Here's Kyle and Joey battling for third, and they take each other out along with championship contender Kurt Busch into the wall. Caution comes out for the first time here on lap 4 out of 10. Let's take a look at what happened on the replay. So as Kyle and Joey were entering the dogleg, Joey going to the inside of Kyle Busch. Eventually, they made contact. Joey Logano was loose. I think he overcorrected. Let me take a look at what happened. I couldn't tell. Maybe he just got loose. And then into the wall along with Kurt Busch, nowhere to go. So unfortunately, his championship hopes are done. He's going to the garage along with Joey Logano. He's done for today. He had a really strong car, but unfortunately was taken out in that wreck. And then Kyle Busch crashes for the second time in a row. And then, in the words of Kyle Busch, it's still 2020. We're going to restart on the sixth lap of the race, and Kevin Harvick scores the halfway bonus, but it won't matter for him as he is looking to win the championship, not points. And McMahon's billboard was in shock after what he has saw flash before his eyes. Along to the right of him, Tim Horton's Cup Series is already having a horrendous race. You know the drill, guys. The green flag is back out in the air until the white flag drops when the leader crosses the line. Brennan Poole now inherits the lead as Kevin Harvick lets him by, but Keslowski now leads the championship for Hunt. Oh, and just to point out that Tyler Reddick, a rookie, is having a very strong day, earned a few points from the halfway bonus, and now making his way past Truex and Johnson. Oh, and Brennan Poole gets loose. Now that allows Brad Keselowski to take the lead back. And Hamlin chasing Keselowski down. And we got a trouble off of two. Two cars in the wall. And it's Ricky Stenhouse Jr. And Ross Chastain almost takes Ryan Preece out as he comes to rest on the track. So the second caution of the day will appear on the eighth lap out of the 10 that we're supposed to run today. Let's check on the replay. So Ross Chastain checks up in front of Ricky Stenhouse Jr. He must have thought he was cleared, but obviously he mistaken that. And did he make contact with Ryan Preece? I'm not sure. We'll check on him later. So the number 47, Ricky Stenhouse Jr. gets the hook going to the garage. And the same thing with Ross Chastain. Definitely not how he wanted to end his season, the last race of the season. So unfortunately he's going to the garage, taking over for Matt Kenseth in the 42 car. And the 37 was on pit row, so he did get damage repairing the right quarter panel. So let's see what happened. The two cars in the wall, then Ross Chastain coming on the track right there. That's where he hit the 37, hitting him in the right quarter panel. So now the 37 has fixed that damage, so we're going into overtime on lap 10 out of 11, and we still have a championship to decide. You have Brad Keselowski as the leader late in the race. Like in the pre-race show, the Penske cars are really good at these short tracks. Can he do it? To his outside is the 11 of Denny Hamlin, rather somewhat quiet in the race as he led half of lap 2, but has a lot of horsepower to unleash here on this restart. How about Kevin Harvick? He's shown promise since Darlington to becoming a champion in this series and the first two-time champ if he can do it today. Look at Brennan Poole and Tyler Reddick, not in the championship four, but are having impressive runs, and I guarantee you that they may come close to winning this event if they just keep doing what they are doing. The pressure, the anxiety, and the temptation all comes down to this as they enter the restart. Truex is hungry right now, I tell you. How about three wide for second once again with Reddick having an advantage, but Hamlin has got a run on the back straightaway. White flag, last lap of the season, as Hamlin makes a pass on Keselowski on the line. Brad goes to the bottom of the track as Denny is up high. On the back stretch, they go. Wow, they touch! They're neck and neck coming into three. Hamlin gets a push from Reddick. Reddick drives it in deep. The 2 and 11 touch again. It's a wild finish here at Phoenix as a Reddick goes around coming home in third. It is too close to call. And what a finish. What a race. Unbelievable. What just happened? We need to take a look at what happened. Here's what happened on the last lap. when Keslowski and Hamlin were battling side by side to the line, and then Reddick trying to make it a three wide photo finish, but it was loose getting in the back Keslowski, and then it was a photo finish at the line, and then Tyler Reddick goes around. Let's take a look at what happened one more time. Again, Tyler Reddick coming around, and according to the finish, Denny Hamlin wins the championship and the race by just a nose at the line. Denny Hamlin delivers it today, getting the job done. Now he's a champion, joining Chase Elliott and Kevin Harvick. Denny Hamlin is your Season 3 champ after an ultimate showdown with Brad Keselowski and Tyler Reddick, almost winning if it wasn't for that spin. But now for the last time of the season, let's take a look at your race results. With just a splitter over the line, Serre Cup Series wins and is your champion. In second is McMan, along with the photo finish with Denny Hamlin, and then aka Serre Cup Series. And then KL42 Racing, what an amazing run he had. If it wasn't for that spin, like I said, then he probably would have won, making it a three wide finish. And then we have Eddie Benzi coming home in fourth. Amazing job he did today. And then with Clark McKee in fifth, who spun around in turns, in the middle of turns one and two, and managed to save that race car from disaster. So that was really good. And then in sixth is Brandon Poole. Another great job he did today. And then seventh is CST31 Racing Network. And Harvick will not be your champion. Okay, enough of that crap. And then eighth, we have the NASCAR LEGO Cup Series. Ninth, Speedy. Nice top 10, Speedy. Really good. Really, really good. And then 10th is NASCAR Mania 2009, driving for Jimmy Johnson. Jimmy Johnson's final time, coming home in 10th for to end his season. And then we have his teammate Rock Bottom Sports Network, aka William Byron, coming home in 11th. Then we have Marco Quir, a really good run for him for a rookie. That was pretty intense. Really good. Awesome. And then 13th, Jay Scott, Mr. NASCAR, and then number 3 car, also good job today. And then 14th, iRacing Fan, number 9. Kind of disappointing, though. I'm pretty sure he would have done better. But still, overall, at least he got a top 15 or top 20, so that's good. And then we have, in 15th, Annan's Review. 16th, Parker Klimek. Then 17th is Just Crab in the 42 car. Really good day for... really good day for 42 car, like Matt Kenseth coming home in 17th out of retirement. I guess that's pretty good. And then 18th we have Triple Boy 3, then 19th Patrick Perry, 20th Spark Cup Series, and 21st Gavin Beers, 22nd Tony Productions, 23rd Random Sports Guy, 24th MCS Racing Network, 25th Denny Hamlin, 26th Connor Kolsuk, 27th Rodco Racing, and then the DNFs, 28th Wahoo Wah, and then number 77 SES Racing Network in the 47, Get a Grip Sports NASCAR coming home in 30th, 31st Icy Fire 2486, and then last but not least, unfortunately, is a championship contender, Tim Hortons Cup Series, scoring 4th in the point standings. So now, after with all the race results being said, let's take a look at the official Season 3 point standings. Alright, so there you have it. Denny Hamlin, Brad Keselowski, Kevin Harvick, Kurt Busch, Alex Bowman, William Byron, Ryan Blaney, Joey Logano, Chase Elliott, Brandon Poole, and Jimmy Johnson round out the top 10 in points. Then rounding out the top 20, we have Kyle Busch, Martin Truex Jr., Eric Jones, Matt Benedetto, Clint Boyer, Eric Almirola, Ryan Newman, Bubba Wallace, Tyler Reddick. That rounds out the top 20. Then you have Austin Dillon, 21st, then Ricky Stenhouse Jr., then Ty Dillon, then the 38 of John Hunter Nemechek, Chris Buescher, the 41 of Cole Custer. Then you have the number 95 of Christopher Bell, Michael McDowell, And then the 77 of Ross Chastain. Then the 37 of Ryan Preece. Then we have two 42s. One being Matt Kenseth. And the other one being Kyle Busch. And then last but not least, we have the 32 of Corey LaJoie. Thank you guys for tuning in for the last race of the season and for an incredible Season 3. And as always, we'll be back in March for Season 4 of the NASCAR 5-Hour Energy Cup Series right after our offseason. But until then, this is Hendrick Fan 24/7, signing off.